It's Sonny and Finn's Wrestling and Video Game Podcast.
What's up, guys? Welcome to episode 24 of the Sonny and Finn Show. I'm Sonny, and I'm one of your hosts. And with me, as always, is Finn Steele.
Hello.
How you doing?
Very good, thank you. How are you?
I'm doing pretty good, thank you very much.
Good, good. It's a two takes this week, I think.
Yeah, just two takes.
Yeah, got the second attempt.
Yeah, the only reason that it sort of didn't work first time is because my microphone wasn't selected on the thing.
Yeah, yeah. So it's not our fault this time.
It's not our fault. Yeah. In fact, I did a flawless intro, I felt.
You did, yeah, it's great.
Yeah.
No one will ever hear it.
No, no.
It's gone forever.
I feel like the second take was strong.
Yeah, it was good.
So, just enjoy it.
Yes.
Just breathe it in and...
Breathe it in, man.
And just realise that it was equally as good as the never-to-be-heard first take.
Yes, absolutely.
We haven't really got any world news this week to report.
No, nothing really happened.
No. Fireman Sam seems to have been off the hook.
Yeah, yeah. No Fireman Sam news this week.
And the weather's gone back to being very... Britain.
Yeah, a bit wet. Still quite warm, but mostly wet.
Okay, there's your weekly Sonny and Finn weather report.
Weather report, yes. Wet.
Wet and hot and a little bit windy.
Yes.
The only thing we're missing is like snow and stuff.
Pretty much, yeah.
And stuff. Like, yeah. I'm really narrowing it down there.
Snow and hurricanes and stuff like that.
We don't really get that in this country.
We don't know. Thank goodness.
Yeah. I don't really want a hurricane in this country.
Me neither.
Okay. Well, that's good.
Or earthquakes. That would be bad too.
Earthquakes?
Yeah, that would suck.
What about typhoons? Nice wrestling time.
Typhoon.
Yeah, I don't know.
Is that the same as a hurricane?
I don't know. I think it's like a water hurricane. Hurricane in the water.
A typhoon?
I think so. Yeah, and it tends to do water.
Right.
Yeah. I remember there being like an RPG or something. Yeah, a move called Typhoon. It was like a water move.
I see.
Like a whirlpool.
And I'm trying to figure out, trying to remember what Typhoon had on his ring attire.
Oh, yeah.
Because obviously Earthquake and Typhoon, 90s WWF tag team. And Typhoon wore red, but I can't remember what the logo was.
Yeah, I don't remember. Before my time.
What do you mean before your time? Before your time of watching wrestling?
Yeah, pretty much, yeah.
Oh, okay. Before your time. You know what you sound like? It makes me sound really old.
Well, you are really old.
Oh.
Just kidding.
No, you're not.
Yeah,
you, that's hurtful what you just said.
You're like what, 50?
Nearly 50.
All right.
I'm like 18 years away. Wait, 19 years away from 50. I'm like making myself older than I actually am.
You are. Yes, you're closer than I am to 50. Yes, that's
the most important thing. That's the takeaway from all of this.
Yeah, pretty much. You're an old man. You're an old, old man.
You look older.
What? No, I don't. Yeah. I look like a 12-year-old.
With a beard.
With a beard. Everyone at work would say, so are you in university while you're working? I was like, no, I'm 28.
Well, people ask you that, do they?
Yeah, yeah. I think I'm like way younger than like a teenager or something. I'm like, no.
And then they're like, well, what are you doing with your life?
Yeah, I'm wasting it on podcasts and YouTube. Anyway, video games.
Guys, we are the Sonny and Finn Show. We are a weekly video game and wrestling podcast that posts every single Friday.
Mm-hmm.
Across all podcast services.
Friday now. A whole day early. You're welcome.
A whole day. Yeah. The thing is, we've done this, right? And it doesn't really change the amount of listens that we get because we're still at the same time difference between episodes.
Yeah, pretty much.
But it comes out on a Friday now.
It does. It's closer to like when the wrestling happens, I guess.
Okay.
One day closer.
Well, it works. That's fine.
It works, yeah.
Let's talk video games.
Okay.
What have you been playing since we last spoke? Well, since we last did the podcast.
Not really. A lot of Overwatch, as usual.
What, really?
Yeah, I know, it's shocking.
Well, you don't really play that.
Yeah, I stopped for a little while, but I'm going to jump back in.
Yeah.
But yeah, other than that, we made Virtue's Last Reward on PlayStation Vita.
Oh, okay. You got the Vita out.
Yeah, yeah.
How are you finding Virtue? Have you played through it, or are you playing through it?
I played through it before on 3DS. Oh. I played through it again, because the newest game in the series came out recently. I played through the second one again, full of trophies mostly, and to like refresh what happened, because, mm-hmm. Boy, it's complicated, a story.
So have you done it?
I'm going through it now.
Oh, okay.
Pretty like the first little playthrough, but there's like 6 or 7 you need to go through.
How long is it?
It depends. It gets a whole lot. It probably takes about 20 or so hours, but each like individual playthrough takes like 5 hours or so, maybe less than that, 2 hours.
Right, okay.
But it's complicated. It's like lots of branching paths and stuff like that.
Right, okay. Is it something that I wouldn't like?
I don't know, you might like it. It's not good. Got a good story to it.
Okay.
You like stories and games, and you like it. It's like a puzzle game.
Is it not like an RPG?
Not really. No.
It sounds like one. Like the name of it.
It does. It's Japanese, but it's like a puzzle game / visual novel kind of thing.
Okay. Well, it sounds quite good.
Yeah, it's cool. Check it out.
Okay. Anything else?
Not really. That's about
right,
it.
Right. Okay. I've been a busy boy this week as far as gaming goes.
Oh yeah.
I've had a lot of free time.
Yeah.
So I've sort of been filling it with gaming.
Awesome.
So, remember last week when I said that I bought the Marvel Ultimate Alliance 2?
Oh yeah.
Well, I played through it. Awesome. Did my first playthrough.
How was it?
And it was good. I enjoyed it a lot. I've gone through as anti-registration.
Nice. I know what that is.
Have you played through it before?
I have, a long time ago.
Have you seen Captain America Civil War?
No.
Okay. So Marvel Ultimate Alliance 2 takes from Captain America Civil War. It basically is a video game version of that.
Neat.
You can either pick sides and you can either sort of go with Captain America or you can go with Iron Man.
Oh, yeah.
I'm with Captain America, and that's anti-registration, which means you don't sign up to be an official superhero.
I see.
So you take you're basically a vigilante.
Yeah.
Okay. So, I really enjoyed it. Love that style game. It's like Diablo
with
Marvel superheroes.
Yeah, that's pretty cool, actually.
And I'm a big fan of it. I really, really like it. It's a lot of fun. Very addictive, even though it's literally just smashing through everything.
Yeah, pretty much.
But it's very good. I've actually bought the first one now.
Oh, yeah.
I bought that one on Xbox One.
Nice.
I'm going to play through that. I did start it, but then I didn't save it, so because it's a really old game.
Yeah, yeah.
I actually physically have to save it as opposed to auto saves. Right.
Yeah, yeah.
And I didn't do it, so it was fine. It's an hour or so wasted of my life. So
yeah, I hate that. I always forget as well.
Yeah.
In a game like that.
But yeah, really good game. I'm on my second playthrough of Ultimate Alliance 2, and I'm obviously going to do it pro registration this time because there's trophies for it.
Of course.
Of course.
Gotta get the trophies.
And obviously you keep your progress from your first playthrough, so your characters are super powerful.
Oh yeah, it's like New Game Plus kind of thing.
Yeah, basically, yeah. Awesome. And it's awesome. It didn't take me that long either, really.
Cool.
What else have I played through? I played through The Wolf Among Us.
Oh yeah, that's a good one.
It's my first playthrough of that.
It's very good.
I played through on Xbox One, and it was excellent.
Mm, so good.
It was like, you know, if you've played a Telltale game, you know exactly what it is, what to expect. But the story's superb. It's, if you haven't played it, it's basically... like fairy tale characters, such as the Big Bad Wolf, who is the main character in this instance.
Mm-hmm.
Beauty and the Beast, you know, that Georgie Porgy, Tweedledee, Tweedledum, Snow White, that sort of thing. And they have been moved from their fairy tale lives into the real world and live in a town called Fable Town.
Yes.
And they have what's called glamours to make them appear in human form, those that need it. It's an excellent game. Very good story.
Very, very good.
Very much looking forward to a second season.
Me too.
Should one happen.
Pretty sure it's going to happen. I think they announced it's going to happen.
It was very popular.
Oh, yeah.
Worth playing if you get the chance. Like every other Telltale game, I experienced a few problems with it.
Yeah, there's a bit...
Only performance issues.
Yeah.
A bit of freezing and then continuing a few seconds later, that sort of thing. But all in all, that's great experience, great game.
Oh, yeah, it's very good. Definitely worth playing if you... if you've downloaded it on Xbox One, I haven't played it yet, because I think it was free on...
Yeah, it was free, yeah.
Yeah. So it's definitely worth checking out.
Oh, for sure. And I've played through the first episode of Batman, a Telltale series.
Sweet. How was it?
Good.
Yeah.
It was good. It was slow. It was longer than most episodes of Telltale games.
Oh, yeah.
I think when I looked after I'd done it, it was 2 hours, 5 minutes.
All right. That's pretty good.
So there's more Bruce Wayne than Batman.
Okay.
I think it, which is cool actually, to be honest, because you don't really get that. All Batman games are pretty much just Batman.
Pretty much.
Yeah, a tiny bit of Bruce Wayne. But this, it follows sort of Bruce in his sort of daily life and the struggles he has in real life and managing being Batman and Bruce Wayne. So it was good. There was some very cool action sequences involving Batman. But it was good. It isn't the most polished of Telltale games, I have to be honest. It's not as attractive as Tales from the Borderlands or The Wolf Among Us.
All right.
It does suffer the same performance issues that all of the Telltale games suffer with.
Yeah, I wonder what's up with that. Do you think they'd have it narrowed down by now?
Considering how many games they make, you would think so.
Yeah.
But I enjoyed it. I mean, I love Batman anyway, and I love the universe that it's set in. So I'm excited to see where it goes. I give the first episode probably 7 out of 10.
Cool, that's fair.
But I'm excited to see how the series goes.
Yeah, definitely. I'll definitely check it out once the whole thing's out. I'll just blast it in one go.
But, yeah, that's fair enough.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it.
I think you're looking at probably a 10-hour experience. I think they're trying to make it a bit more than what you would usually get. Although The Wolf Among Us was about 9 hours as well.
So. Yeah.
That's pretty much it.
Awesome.
A bit of gaming news this week. Not a great deal, but we do have some gaming news.
Yeah, a bit more than last week, hopefully.
I think so. I mean, have you got some as well?
You got
a couple of bits. Your usual bits.
Yeah.
Okay.
I got one bit.
One bit?
Yeah.
Okay.
I think all you know it's going to be about.
I do. I've got it written down myself, actually.
Okay, okay, cool. Yeah.
But I'll let you read it out. That's your thing.
Okay.
Okay. Good. I'll go first. So the Xbox One S was released yesterday.
Sweet.
And what a beautiful looking machine it is.
It does look pretty nice.
I really want one.
Yeah.
But I have no use for one.
Yeah, same here. It's like, I just bought my Xbox One pretty recently. Yeah. Like, just before they announced the Xbox One S, I was like, oh, man.
It's just waiting. I had a 500 gig white Xbox One. And I was like, right, I want a bigger hard drive because for some reason games just eat the hard drive on Xbox.
Yeah, ridiculous.
So I upgraded to a black 1 terabyte. And then like 2 weeks later, they announced the Xbox One S at E3. And I was like, well that's great.
Yeah, figures.
But it's a gorgeous looking console. Reviews are in for it and they've been very positive.
Yeah.
You know, it's basically the Xbox One, a little bit more powerful. Hmm. It will make, the reviews are saying basically that it will make some games run faster and not make really a shred of difference to most others.
Yeah, pretty much.
It's basically a slimmer Xbox One with 4K and HDR abilities.
Yeah, it's like the slimmer Xbox 360 they brought out.
Yeah, but it's a gorgeous looking console.
Yep. Yeah, it's pretty nice.
I mean, if you haven't got an Xbox One already, and we're sort of, you know, waiting.
You're thinking about
For whatever reason. Hmm. You know, now's the time to go out and buy one because this is a great looking console.
Yeah, it is.
The controllers are awesome as well. They've got like a grip at the back. So, you know, like the Xbox One controllers that we have, mm-hmm. they don't have a grip. At least they have like a rubber grip on the back.
All right.
Which is really cool.
Yeah.
Somebody purchased a leaked copy of No Man's Sky.
Oh, yeah.
For an obscene amount of money.
Why would you... Yeah, that's a bit weird.
I mean, I'm not hyped for the game, especially not hyped enough to go and pay, was it $1,500, I think, or something
like
that?
Yeah, that's ridiculous.
Or something like that? Something anyway, crazy. The person who did this and has bought this pre-release copy, so it hasn't even got the day one patch on it, bear in mind.
Yeah.
Because there is one coming, hence why there's no reviews for it yet.
Mm-hmm.
The likelihood is... that it isn't going to have reviews before the game comes out, which comes out next week.
Yeah.
Because that pre-release patch has only just been finished.
Oh, right, okay.
So, I mean, it makes sense for them to not review it without that patch.
It does.
Yeah. So, this person has reached the center of the galaxy, which apparently, like, finishes the game.
Yeah.
Or at least the story. Is there a story to it? Or at least...
I have no idea.
Finishes the campaign aspect of the game, I guess. We know nothing about this game, really, still. And this person said that it took them around 30 hours.
Yeah. I think I read that he's like rushed through it a bit. He skipped some things. It's like 30 hours if you're like sprinting for the goal, without exploring too much and all that. But Steven said that's like, it's not that much. Considering there's supposed to be like a ridiculous amount of planets and it's just like a huge universe, 30 hours doesn't seem that long.
But if he's plowed straight through the game and not really took much time to explore, trade, anything like that,
yeah,
then, you know, 30 hours isn't a short game.
It's not.
That's a long time to spend with the game.
Yeah, it is. It's just, I don't know. Kind of a game like this, I expected more. Because, like, some like RPGs, like Skyrim or something, you spent 100 hours and it's, like, nowhere near the size of supposedly what this game is.
The thing is, Skyrim has a story.
Yeah.
And it has side stories. And it has millions of other things to do. I don't think this is a game that can be compared to something like Skyrim.
Yeah.
Again, I know we don't know much about it.
Yeah.
But I don't know. I'm still very intrigued. I still don't know what this game is going
to
be.
Yeah, I'm intrigued for it. I'm definitely looking forward to seeing like reviews and stuff and like gameplay videos. I don't know if I'll pick it up myself yet. If it gets like good reviews, then I probably will.
Yeah, if we're sort of hitting between 8 and 10s here, I'll pick it up day one, provided we've got the reviews.
Yeah, if there's reviews by then.
But I don't know. I mean, there's intrigue there.
Yeah, definitely.
But so, I mean, 30 hours. I would imagine that a normal person who hasn't purchased a ridiculous Lee Priced copy.
Yeah.
And doesn't want to blitz through it to tell people that he's done it before the game comes out like he's some kind of hero. Because he's not.
He's not.
We don't really understand why he's done it.
He's just a rich idiot.
Yeah. Or is he even rich? We don't even know.
Yeah. Maybe now he's a poor idiot. He spent all his money on the
maybe
No Man's Sky.
Just an idiot.
Yeah, maybe he's just a big, massive idiot.
Yeah. I think most people will take their time with it.
I think so.
This guy, you know, he put some videos and stuff on, which have now been removed, of course.
Shocking.
And, you know, it sounds like he just wanted to be that person who had the game before anybody else.
Yeah, he wanted to
play played through it, and he can say he's done it before it's ever been released into the world.
Yeah. I don't get it personally, but...
We'll see. I know I don't understand it either.
Yeah.
I don't understand it either. But, so 30 hours it took him, and I would assume that's rushing through it.
Yeah.
I think it's probably, you know, Hello Games, that's who makes it, right?
Oh, yes.
Yeah, they basically said that it was going to be between 40 and 100 hours, depending on how you approached it.
Oh, yes, most likely.
So I don't think people should be concerned.
No, I think that sounds about right.
Yeah. Who's to say that you're going to even want to explore the game for 40 to 100 hours,
well, yeah.
or even 30? We don't know, we'll see. Disney Infinity. We reported months ago now that they were closing Disney Infinity down.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, and they are officially announcing that Disney Infinity is being shut down.
Yeah.
However, it's not been the most clear cut of stories.
Yeah, I read that.
Okay, so if you own the game on console, you know, Xbox, it releases on everything. So if you if you've got it on home console, you won't have access to online services from September the 30th.
It's a shame.
You can still play the game.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure.
The PC versions and the mobile versions are going to be shut down completely. So they're going to be unplayable.
Right, okay. That's a bit shit. That's a bit crap.
It is.
I wonder why.
Oh, wait, here we go. So the PC version of the game brought directly through the Disney Infinity website will not be playable or available after September the 30th.
Huh.
After March the 3rd, 2017, the Windows Store version will not be playable.
Okay.
The Steam version of the game will function normally, but without online support indefinitely.
Right.
So if you bought it through Steam, you can still play this single player stuff if you really want to.
Online stuff. And
that's the same as consoles.
Yeah.
But everything else, shut down.
Weird.
Completely. That's an interesting one.
I guess there must be some sort of online connectivity even on single player and like the Windows Store version and Disney Infinity version.
What, the mobile version?
Yeah,
that's weird.
I don't know. I don't get it.
Parents have spent like loads of money on this game.
Yeah.
So you're going to be pretty peeved if your child can't play this game anymore.
Yeah. That's dumb.
I have this game on PS4.
You do?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But, and I really like it.
Yeah.
I don't play it often enough to really give a shit that the online is being shut down.
Yeah.
In fact, I don't think I've ever played online.
No.
I've downloaded a few levels from one of the many creative souls out there in the world, but
it is
what it is.
Yeah, honestly, I don't even know what this even is as a game. But I know there's like little figures you collect and kind of like Skylanders, but other than that...
There's campaigns for them.
Yeah?
Yeah, and I think a lot of people were really sort of attracted to the toy box feature, which you could sort of make worlds and planets, like Little Big Planet sort of thing, but on a big sort of...
Bigger version.
Toy box level, I guess.
Yeah, that's cool.
It's very cool. Very expensive, but it's very cool. So, a key figure from the development of the original Shenmue will be contributing to Shenmue 3.
Yes, I heard about that.
If I'm not pronouncing this correct, please do jump in.
Okay.
But Keiji Akuyaso...
Let's know.
Okay. ...has joined the development team working on Shenmue 3.
Excellent.
He was with the original Shenmue sort of from the original game.
Yep.
And he sort of worked on Shenmue 2 until the game was near completion.
Yeah.
Not all the way through development.
Yeah. But he's like a big part of the older games. So I'm happy to see him back. That's great.
I'm still very, very unsure about Shenmue 3.
Yeah. I'm still wanting to be good. I think it will.
I hope. to be honest, I think you may as well sort of give that point to me now for the fact that the remasters that you think are coming.
They are coming. It's happening. I believe. All you have to do is believe.
Man, you are deluded. That's what you are.
I'm not. It's happening.
No. This game, is, we're not going to see this game for a long, long time.
Yeah, so well, not semi-through, but...
Why would they sort of spend their time working on remasters? We've had this argument so many times.
But they give, just give it to like some other studio at Sega to work on. So here, work on this. We'll already get the games made. Just make them work on new consoles and...
Licensing issues and time are going to stop that from ever happening.
They can just strip out like the license stuff and whatever.
No, because... Because it's not going to give people who are new to the series the real Shenmue experience.
Well, what was even licensed in that game? I don't even remember.
The Sega games and stuff like that. Surely that would really be a problem.
But that's published by Sega, so who cares?
There will be licensed stuff in that game.
Yeah, yeah.
Even stuff that we wouldn't have noticed.
Yeah, probably. You're probably right.
Yeah.
God damn it. The game's, I'm still believe it's coming. It's coming.
Yeah, it's not.
Trust me.
Nah. It's not happening.
Finn prediction.
Finn bullshit prediction.
We'll see.
PlayStation VR is nearing release.
Yay.
We're about 2 and a bit months away from its official launch.
Excited.
I'm very excited. On the Japanese PlayStation blog, apparently Drive Club VR is a launch title.
Oh,
but there's no apparently about it. It's going to be a launch title, at least in Japan. Nothing confirmed this side of the world at the minute, but Drive Club is a game that was released worldwide.
Yeah.
People will want that Drive Club VR.
Oh, yeah. I like the idea of just like having actually being able to sit in the car and look around.
Yeah.
Like look in the mirrors and stuff. That'd be awesome.
Cockpit view and realistic 3D audio are mentioned as features in the game.
Neat.
Yeah, I mean, that'd be awesome. I'd be.
Yeah.
I do own Drive Club.
Oh, yeah.
No, I don't know if it'll be a separate download or, like a separately priced download add-on or whether they'd sort of just give it you as a freebie for owning Drive Club, because Drive Club isn't being worked on anymore because that studio has disbanded.
Oh, yeah. Weird.
So, I don't know. I imagine that's going to release worldwide and not just in Japan.
Yeah.
Because it'll get people's backs up otherwise.
Yeah, seriously.
Yeah. But I'm interested in that. I think there's some very cool looking environments in Drive Club.
Yeah. It's a pretty looking game.
It's a really good looking game. Considering how much trouble that game was in when it first came out.
Yeah.
It turned a corner. No pun intended with regards to driving there. But,
oh, yeah.
Really good game.
Awesome.
Have you got it?
I don't, but I'll be happy to check it out if it comes with VR and stuff.
Right. Have you played it?
I haven't, but I've seen other people play it and talk about it and say how good it is.
Right.
So, yeah. I'm talking from...
It is very good. It is really, really good.
Yeah. It looks pretty.
Okay. What else we got? What have you got for us?
I've got some more. Overwatch news.
Oh, yeah!
Sound the Overwatch news air horn.
We should have like an Overwatch news jingle.
Yeah. So Overwatch news. So Overwatch news. So Overwatch news.
Yeah. There you go. That's your official jingle for the weekly Overwatch news, because it is weekly.
Pretty much. So Blizzard added, out of nowhere, a completely free update, as are all the updates to Overwatch. Adds summer games attires and emotes and things. So obviously the Olympic stuff. And the skins are all based around the character's country of origin. So you've got like McCree in like an American flag looking get up. Tracy's got like an American a British flag, and like Kenji's got like a Japan thing going on. It's all very cool. And also added a new game mode for the brawl, which is called Lucio Ball. If you ever played Rocket League, it's basically Rocket League, but with Lucio.
There you go.
It's super fun. It's so much fun. Check it out if you've got Overwatch. No reason not to. It's completely free. Just comes in a normal update.
I think it's only running until maybe after the Olympics is finished.
Yeah, I think so. I think it's like a month
It
goes on for.
So the Olympics starts next week.
Yeah.
This is cool. I mean, I haven't checked it out myself yet, but I did see it and it piqued my interest.
Oh, yeah.
So I'll probably check it out. I mean, I'm sure the update is downloaded to my PS4.
Probably.
I have it in rest mode all the time, so it does whatever it does.
No, it's a lot of fun. Football, but Lucio.
Right.
Good. And lots of new skins and emotes and all stuff like that.
Are the skins and emotes sticking around, or are they disappearing when the patch disappears?
I think you can only unlock them during the events, but they'll stick around afterwards if you unlock them. If you know what I mean. You won't be able to unlock them after the event, but you'll still have them if you unlock them.
Got you.
Yeah.
Okay, that sounds cool.
Which is pretty cool. And it's completely free, which is awesome.
That's great.
Yeah.
I didn't really. But I downloaded the new Division DLC, because I had the season pass, so Underground was finally released on PS4 this week. To be honest, I played the division for I played it for about 5 minutes and turned it off.
Yeah, fair enough.
Because it's pissed me off. Like, I not the update itself. I didn't even get that far.
Yeah.
Like a supply drop, like dropped on the map, and I was like, right, I'm gonna go for this. And then guys who were just way overpowered.
Yeah.
Compared to my character, just blitzed me, and I was like, fuck this, and turned it off.
Yeah.
It's quite apparent that I need to put hours into that game to get up to speed.
Yeah.
And I'm not convinced that it's hours that I'm willing to put in.
Yeah.
I want to do the update because I've paid for the season pass. I mean, it's dead money now, so I've got it regardless of whether I want it or not.
Yeah.
You know, I want to play it because I love the game. Loved the game. Past tense.
Yeah. That's kind of why I stopped playing it and why I traded in my copy, because I could see this happening. I could see this, like, getting into the game, getting destroyed by, like, overleveled arseholes, and just being like, I don't want to play this anymore.
It's not even actual people, it's...
Just NPCs. Normal NPCs, yeah.
Yeah.
But yeah, I don't have time for it, that kind of stuff anymore.
Yeah.
Sorry, Ubisoft.
Yeah, fair enough. I will do it. I just need to find... I need, like, a week off to, like, be able to sort of do this.
Yeah, need some motivation.
Yeah. WWE 2K17
yay
is coming in a couple of months' time.
In October.
And finally, we've started to see some screens, one video, and the roster has started to be revealed.
Yay.
Now, the video released was of Brock Lesnar's entrance with Paul Heyman.
Mm-hmm.
And it looks exactly the same as WWE 2K16.
Yeah.
We've still got the burn victims in the crowd.
God damn it.
The face animations are okay, yeah. I guess.
I mean, it's still a good-looking game. It's just 2K16 was a good-looking game.
2K15 is a good-looking game.
Yeah, it's still all the same.
But it's not changing, and that's where the problem lies. The Raw logo was the Raw logo that has just passed.
That's bad.
It's forgivable for now.
Yeah, I mean, I'm sure they'll like, patch that in later, I guess.
The new era of Raw is only 2 weeks old.
Yeah, yeah.
And they've still got 2 and a bit months to get this game out. Nearly 3 months.
I think they're going to do it. I think it's going to be all the old stuff again.
Yeah. That's going to be annoying.
It is. It's kind of like their track record.
They've announced some of the roster.
Yeah.
So this is going to happen every Tuesday over at IGN. They're going to get my words out. They're going to reveal new members of the roster each week.
Cool.
So far, and this was the August 2nd announcement, we have Aiden English.
Cool.
WWE Hall of Famer Booker T.
Nice.
Flying Brian Pillman.
Right.
Just Brian Pillman. I like to call him Flying Brian.
Nice.
That was his old name.
Yeah, it was.
Okay. Brie Bella.
Brie Mode.
Yeah, there you go. Chris Jericho.
Cool.
Eric Rowan.
Nice.
Heath Slater.
Cool.
Jimmy and Jey Uso.
Oos.
Oh.
Yeah.
Jim the Anvil Neidhart.
Cool.
Connor from The Ascension. Oh, yeah, and yeah. Victor. Nikki Bella.
Cool. Because okay. I do Entertainment or that. Starting against it.
R-Truth.
Nice.
Simon Gotch.
Cool.
And The Ultimate Warrior.
Cool.
That's not all.
All right, okay.
You ready for some crappy news?
I'm ready. Hit me with it.
So The Shining Stars.
Uh huh.
Primo and Epico. They've been The Shining Stars for a couple of months now.
They have.
They are in the game.
Cool.
But as Los Matadors, Diego and Fernando.
God damn it.
Come on.
That's so stupid.
This is why we get so annoyed with these games. This is something that has to be fixed before the game comes out.
Seriously.
But as they are part of the roster reveal,
mm-hmm.
I don't think they're going to get changed.
Yeah, probably not.
What I predict is they're going to look like the Matadors,
mm-hmm.
but they're going to have the Shining Stars music and entrance.
That'd be hilarious. yeah, that's dumb. I'll bet it will be DLC, Shining Stars DLC. There's no one to want, but...
Yeah, but Diego and Fernando are already in the game.
Yeah.
That is stupid. I imagine, I haven't looked, but I imagine that there is backlash to this already.
Yeah, I'm sure there is.
As soon as Diego and Fernando were announced on that IGN stream, I bet there was people fuming.
Yeah, it's typing away like mad. What the fuck is this?
I was scrolling down the list and I was like, right, yep, that's... Diego and Fernando. You cannot be serious.
I mean, they had them last year, so I thought, well, it's an easy... It's needing two extra guys to port them in from last year's game.
What annoys me about WWE games
yeah.
is the fact that it's the BS excuse of, we can't really update them. That is hogwash.
Yeah, it's dumb.
Right? Because the NBA 2K games that they release year in, year out,
mm-hmm.
they're updated all the time.
That's true.
The players even have the up-to-date trainers that they wear.
Wow.
From the last game that they played.
Jesus Christ.
And the NBA play 80-plus games per year, per season.
That's crazy.
And it's made by 2K, published by 2K.
That is weird. Weird double standard there.
What they need to do is get rid of the company that makes the game.
Mm-hmm. Ukes. So
obviously, yeah, get rid of Ukes. I think their time is up.
Yeah. Their time is up. Our time is now. You can't see me. My time is now.
Let 2K publish it because they obviously, well, I mean, people are going to buy the game regardless of it. Me and you could publish it.
Yeah, pretty much.
Sonny and Finn presents WWE 17.
Yeah.
Great. People are still buying it. People are like, who the hell are these idiots? No one cares. Let's buy the game.
Pretty much.
I just don't understand. Like, make the game so you can update it easily. So that, or give us the option to edit the wrestlers.
Mm.
Like, it's fine having community creations there, but I don't want four different versions of Seth Rollins sitting in my downloaded superstars.
Yeah.
I don't want Los Matadors and then Primo and Epico in my custom superstars. I want Primo and Epico just on the game.
Yeah,
I'm never going to be them, but I want them there. Because I want the game to be up to date. Otherwise, you may as well just have WWE 2K16.
Yeah, it's weird. It's like, it's called 2K17, but it's like, well, like, the superstars from last year, it's like a year behind. It's like, it should be called 2K15 again.
Were the Shining Stars, the Matadors part of a DLC pack for this year's?
They were, yeah.
They were part of the NXT pack. Rising Stars pack.
Yeah.
And even then they'd gone.
Yeah, exactly.
Before that DLC pack had even come out, they weren't even around anymore.
Oh, God. That is pretty ridiculous.
I'm angry at it.
Yeah.
I am angry at it. Just
rightly so.
It annoys me because other sports games do it right.
Yeah.
Like every other sport in the world. Okay, not every other sport in the world because there's a handball game and there's like a Tour de France game. People don't give a shit about those games. Sports that people... the major franchise sports games.
Yeah.
FIFA, NBA, NFL, NHL, MLB.
Yeah.
They do the job right.
They do.
It's updated. It's just... better.
Pretty much.
Better than how the WWE games have been done for the last few years.
Yeah, WWE's got the short end of the stick. It sucks.
I think the short end of the stick is Ukes.
Yeah, I think so. I think they're the weak link in this whole thing.
Yeah, don't let EA anywhere near it.
No.
Do not let EA get the WWE license ever.
Yeah, give it to some, I don't know, someone who cares about wrestling. Somebody who's done wrestling good in the past. I don't know.
We just did a bunch of videos where we played SmackDown Here Comes the Pain, which is fantastic, but even better than that, we played WWF No Mercy.
Yes.
And all the way through like the videos that we made, we were sort of saying how great the animations were on the moves and how everything was just perfect.
Yeah.
And better than it is now.
Definitely.
And this game it's got to be pushing nearly 15 years old, is it, surely?
Yeah.
Like, even more than that, I would say.
Probably. You know what, 2001, I think?
And that is an outstanding wrestling game using a very outdated engine.
Yeah. And it's so much more fun to play than the...
Yeah, it is.
than the new ones.
But my hype for WWE 2K17 has gone down somewhat since I saw the Brock video and since the announcement for the roster so far.
Yeah, mine too.
Which is a shame, because I was really excited for it.
Yeah.
But, I mean, to be honest, I'm so sick of 2K16 that I've gone back to play 15.
Oh, yeah.
And that wasn't even good.
Yeah. I don't know. God damn it. Gosh darn it.
Finn.
Hello.
What's being released in August that we can buy?
Well, I'm glad you asked.
Oh.
Glad you asked.
Glad.
Yeah.
How posh are you?
I know, I'm so posh.
You're really posh. Glad.
Glad. Grass.
Bath.
So, we've got games of August. It's a good month. Not as good as September, October, but pretty good still.
Okay.
Start off, we talked about earlier, the Division DLC Underground came out August 2nd. Got a game called Abzu.
I was so excited for the Division DLC, going back to it. I was so excited for it. But they've changed the game so much that I've just been left behind.
All right, yeah.
It isn't like Destiny. Like, Destiny was kind to players.
Yeah, Destiny mixed things up a bit, yeah.
Destiny did their updates, but didn't leave players behind who maybe hadn't picked the game up for a while.
Yeah.
Like me, I didn't pick it up until the three DLCs were released, so... I stopped playing it, and then I went back in after the Taken King, and not only was the game better, it hadn't left me behind and I could just carry on at my own leisure and play it.
Yeah, yeah. That's cool. Because, yeah, like, difficulty modes and stuff like that.
Which... Yeah, the Division hasn't done that.
No, that's a shame. But, yeah, we've got a game called Abzu, which is basically Journey, but underwater.
I've seen this. Hmm. It's part of the PlayStation deal at the minute where if you there's four indie games. If you buy all of them, you'll get them at a reduced price or something.
Oh, yeah.
It looks good. I'm not sure if there's... If it's my sort of thing, I haven't played Journey, so...
Journey's very good. To be honest, kind of getting sour in these kind of games now. Not sour, but just kind of bored of them, I guess. Because I played the Journey, which is nice, but I don't know if I'd want to do it again, just underwater, if you know what I mean.
Okay, is it made by the same people?
I don't know, actually. I think so.
Okay, is it too arty for you, like inside?
Yeah, pretty much. A bit artsy.
Okay.
But I don't know, it could be fun.
Right.
Not an awful lot of gameplay, which is always bothers me. But, yeah. Also got Batman, which we talked about earlier, episode 1.
Yeah, go play it. It's like the, if you want a taste of it, the first episode's $4.99.
Yeah, bargain. Got a Little King's Story, which is a game that came out a long time ago on the Wii. It's got an HD remaster, I believe, and it's coming out on PC first this month.
Just PC, or?
Just PC so far. I don't think anything they've got listed on there at the minute. I'm pretty sure it's coming to PS4 and everything as well eventually.
Okay.
It's a nice little game. Check it out. Also got No Man's Sky, finally, after several delays and... God knows what else. It's finally coming out this month.
So much hype for this game. Not so from much. Us, just in general.
Yeah.
Like, the hype is real, but if it's disappointing, or it's even worse than that, just garbage, then there's going to be a lot of angry people.
Yeah. I hope it's good.
I hope it's good.
But I'm not sure if it will be.
No, I'm not either.
We'll see. We've also got Grow Up, which was announced at E3 from Ubisoft.
Which is the sequel to Grow Home.
That's it, yep. We also got Metroid Prime Federation Force on 3DS.
What's that?
It's like a multiplayer 3DS game with Metroid. It's basically nothing to do with Metroid Prime. It just slapped that label on it to make people buy it.
Would it be fair to say that the Metroid license has been fucked up?
Pretty much.
Mm-hmm.
It sucks. I love Metroid
what
so much.
What a shame. Real shame.
I own every Metroid game, except for like Pinball, stuff like that. But I love Metroid, and I've just ruined it.
Like, the original Metroid games and the good ones on, I think, the GameCube as well.
Metroid Prime games
were just awesome.
So good.
But now, you know, since the Wii came in, they just started abusing licenses left, right, and center, making, you know, games like, they had to use the motion controller and gimmicky sort of things. And
Metroid Prime 3 was good. And then Metroid Other M, I didn't mind it so much, but it got pretty slated. It wasn't the best. The story was dumb, but it's too easy. But I wouldn't mind it too much.
Okay.
But yeah, it's kind of when it starts to go downhill and people stop caring about Metroid, sadly. Okay. But yeah, after that we've got F1 2016.
Okay, I haven't played one for a few years. They're very hard games, so they are very good games, but they're very difficult.
Yes, and also the only like sports franchises that actually give you the year they come out rather than the year ahead. Like 2K17 is coming out this year. FIFA 17 is coming out this year in 2016, in 2016.
Well, the Formula One season isn't that long.
Yeah, I guess so. I guess it kind of makes sense.
Well, FIFA will... I mean, I'm still playing FIFA 16.
Yeah.
And the 17 season's about to start. And obviously, it came out in 2015.
Yeah, that's so how they do it.
Yeah.
Okay, it makes sense now.
Don't go out FIFA like that.
No, I'm just saying.
Don't go out FIFA like that.
We've also got a second Neo demo. Neo is like the Samurai Dark Souls demo a little while ago, which is very good. It's very difficult.
The one set in Japan?
Yeah, pretty much.
Okay.
So yeah, like the first demo, second one's coming, check it out.
When's that? What date's that?
It's August 23rd.
Right.
Sorry, to be giving the dates. After that, the week after that, I'd like to know, the same day of that, got Deus Ex Mankind Divided.
Yeah, this is one I'm interested in. I don't know if I'll day one it. I might wait for it to come down towards the end of the year, but love the last one.
Last one's excellent.
Been tempted to play it again because I have it on Xbox One. Nice. 360 backwards compatible, of course. I think because I think it was free.
Yep, probably. I think it was. But yeah, I love the last game. I'll probably get this day one, just because I'm a big fan of Deus Ex and stuff.
Fair enough. Love the style. Really good style.
Very cool. After that, same day, Madden NFL 17. Meh.
Mm-hmm. I won't play that. I'm not an American football guy.
No, neither was scared by that, I don't think. Also, on the same day, King of Fighters 14.
Christ.
Which is like it's basically Street Fighter, but with different beat 'em up someone else.
Right.
To always use like 2D.
Isn't every beat 'em up like that?
Pretty much. Yeah, now you mention it. But it's SNK, I think, who makes this one.
Yes, it is. Yeah, that's right.
That sounds right. But it's the first game in the series to use actual 3D models as opposed to like 2D sprites. So that's something.
Right.
Yeah, it's pretty
good. I'm sure it'll be fine. I mean, I'm sure they'll use it in fighting game tournaments and stuff like that.
It's very like, what do they call it? Niche sort of franchise. No, me neither. Not that enterprises.
I like fighters. I just, you know, I draw the line at, you know, I like the core three. I like Street Fighter, I like Mortal Kombat, and I like Tekken.
Yeah, that's fair enough. Yeah, King Fighter's very more like in-depth, more hardcore than like the Street Fighters and Mortal Kombat and all that.
Right.
But yeah, the week after that, we have Attack on Titan, Wings of Freedom, based on the popular anime.
This, I am curious about this. Now, I've wanted to watch the anime. I haven't.
It's very good.
A lot of people say it's good. It's long.
Yeah.
But I like the idea of Titans. I know we've talked about this before, how I like Godzilla and Kaiju and all that other stuff. This intrigues me. That's why I like God of War so much. Enormous bosses and this kind of crap. So
yeah.
I'm interested in it. I'll probably pick it up when it's very cheap later on in the year.
I'll be waiting for reviews on this one because there's a good chance it might suck.
Oh, yeah, I think it'll suck. But I think it's down to, I think a lot of the times, maybe personal preference with these sort of things.
Yeah, definitely.
Because you're looking at a very specific market with that.
Definitely, yeah. But yeah, definitely watch it anyway. I think it's on Netflix. So
yeah, it is, yeah.
It's awesome. Check it out.
While you're on Netflix, go and have a look at Stranger Things.
Okay.
It's very, very good. It's like an 80s... It's set in the 80s, and it's done like an 80s television show. It's live action. It's not animated or anything. It's very, very good.
Cool.
Has Winona Ryder in it, and we've just watched all 8 episodes, and it was fantastic.
Sweet. I'll check it out.
That's a recommendation from me there, guys. Enjoy.
Cool. So on August 30th, we have yet another World of Warcraft expansion, World of Warcraft Legion.
How many World of Warcraft expansions can they possibly bring out?
I know. Apparently people are still playing it. Who knew? I've never played it personally. I'm more of a Final Fantasy XI guy. But yeah.
This is one thing that's uber popular though.
Yeah.
That no one's ever going to be able to fuck with.
Yeah, pretty much. It's one of those things.
Yeah.
It's never going away. It's here forever.
Yeah, it is.
What's got on August 30th, Resident Evil 4 re-release, yet again.
Jesus.
It's on PS4 and Xbox One.
Now, this is the best one that's been released.
Better than 6 and 5.
It's better than 6 and 5.
Yeah.
But, Jesus, you can buy this on any console you want. I think you can even get it on your phone.
Yeah, I think so.
I think if I went on the App Store on my iPhone now, I could download Resident Evil 4.
It wouldn't surprise me.
It's ridiculous. You can... I mean, fine. If you want to play through it again, it's great. It truly is. It's the last good Resident Evil game.
Yeah. If somehow you still haven't played it after all these re-releases and stuff, yeah, then
they forced it down your throat for all this time and you haven't played it, then download it on your PlayStation 4 or Xbox One.
Definitely.
It's only £15, whatever.
Yeah.
In fact, when that's released, I imagine they'll bring all three out in a bundle.
Probably. Wouldn't surprise me.
So you can play 4 and never play 5 and 6. 5's okay. 6 sucks.
5's okay, yeah. 6.
Yeah, you know how we feel about 6. If you listen to this show regular, you know that we do not like Resident Evil 6.
Yeah.
Sucks.
Also coming out this month, there's no date attached to it, but Darkest Dungeon, which is a PC indie game, which has been out for a while, is coming to PS4 and Vita. It's very nice. Very hardcore and hard.
The Vita owners all love that.
Yeah, definitely. Also got, again, no date, but the Fallout 4 Nuka World DLC is coming out this month.
I've got a feeling. I feel like Fallout 4 is better on Xbox One than it is PS4.
Yeah, probably.
I feel like it's been better managed.
Yeah, I don't think PS4 has like mods or anything yet.
I think I think there's trouble getting them over to PS4. So
that sucks.
I think it will happen eventually, but I think they're struggling to do it.
Yeah. Also, Inside is apparently coming to PS4 this August.
Yeah. Is it going to be worth playing through it again for the platinum?
Nope. Right. If I knew it was coming to PS4, I probably would have waited and bought it on PS4. God damn it.
if it's like a fiver towards the end of the year, I'm just going to get the platinum on it.
Yeah, it's probably worth that. Nothing else. And that's been a trip for August.
Right, okay.
Yeah.
Solid month. September is a very much a sunny month.
Yes, yeah, it's a thin month as well, because Final Fantasy 15 is coming out.
Oh, yeah, of course. But of course, FIFA 17 and Pro Evolution Soccer 2017 come out then as well.
My favorite.
I am very excited. And you will hear me get an erection for those games on the first podcast in September when I will be gushing about them.
Good to know. Oh, Dragon Quest 7 comes out next month. Neat.
I've done 120 something hours on FIFA 16.
Nice.
Because Xbox One, you know, gives you that, gives you soul destroying facts of how long you've played. Yeah, I love me some sports.
Good. Good. I was looking at October games. There's a lot coming out in October. Jesus Christ.
Yeah, I thought
that's expensive month.
Especially with VR as well.
Yeah, exactly. VR, we've got Last Guardian, we've got Elder Scrolls V again, Skyrim, World of Final Fantasy, Batman VR, 2K17, Rise of Tomb Raider PS4, Gears of War 4, Mafia 3, Jesus Christ. Drive Club VR, you've just said.
Is Drive Club VR on there?
Yeah, yeah, apparently. October 13th.
So that's the date. Is Batman VR October 13th?
That's just listed as October, very specific date.
They need to bring it out on launch with VR.
Yeah. Oh, Titanfall 2 as well.
What's that?
Titanfall 2. Add that to the list.
Great.
Yeah.
That's at least £500 worth of stuff you've just listed there.
Pretty much. An expensive month.
That's without VR.
Yeah. Bloody hell.
I don't think Batman VR and those sort of experiences will be full price games.
Probably not.
If Batman VR's £50, I'll be living.
That'd be ridiculous, yeah. But yeah, I reckon like £20 or another.
That's fine.
Yeah. But yeah, that's it.
Okay.
Games of the month.
Let's talk wrestling.
Okay. What do you have notes? I have notes.
You have notes? I do. Okay.
Well.
So this is week two of the brand extension.
It is, yeah.
How did you feel about it? Were you as stoked for it as you were for the first week?
It's not as good as last week, I don't think. But then it was never going to be, really, was it? Because last week's Raw was pretty special.
Yeah, Raw set the bar pretty high last week. So I think it's always going to be fairly difficult to up it.
Yeah, for sure. But it was all right. I liked it. Still better. Yeah,
I mean, it was fine. I watched the whole thing. I enjoyed it just fine.
Yep.
I enjoyed SmackDown just fine.
Yeah, me too.
I thought SmackDown was better this week. But let me just, as every week, pull up the Raw quick results.
Okie dokie. So it started off with... Sasha Banks coming out. It's good to see the women starting off Monday Night Raw.
Yeah, nice and refreshing, I thought.
Yeah, it was awesome. Obviously calling out Charlotte. Well, didn't think she called out Charlotte, but Charlotte came down. Had a confrontation there. And then, of all people to interrupt, bloody Chris Jericho. With his quiet, which I love.
Yeah, it was pretty cool. I mean, what's interesting is, I mean, you can tell that WWE tinker with the crowd noises and stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Just by looking at the WWE Snapchat.
Mm.
Because they showed that bit on the WWE Snapchat.
Oh, yeah.
And obviously it was filmed from the crowd. And like the crowd reaction or the crowd noises are way louder.
Yeah.
Well, than it is on TV. I know it's a polished production and whatever. But
one thing I've noticed when this new era Raw and SmackDown, the crowd seems still quieter for some reason. I don't know if they've turned it down to what it was normally.
They turn it up and down whenever they want. Whenever they see fit.
Oh, strange.
Yeah, it's weird. I don't know.
But what's his name? Kevin Dunn, that's his name. He's messing around with the crowd noises.
Yep. God damn.
But yeah, so good show, Coe. It's like, how dare you talk about Ric Flair like that and talk about his daughter and all that. And then Enzo Amore came out to Sasha's aid. Without the cast. On his own, yeah. And another hilarious back and forth between Enzo and Jericho.
Yeah, it was a nice little, some good, cool little back and forth between him and Sasha as well, I thought.
Yeah, yeah. So, yeah,
yeah, I thought, I enjoyed the opening segment. I thought it went on maybe a little too long.
Yeah, maybe a little bit.
And then...
it's 3 hours to film. What can you do?
This is true, but if you're going to come on down and do an opening promo, at least make sure, you know, your material's not going to drag on.
Yeah, that's true.
But it was fine. And then Mick Foley came down and made a mixed tag team match. For right now.
Yes.
So
bang bang, have a nice day.
Yeah. Yeah, so let's run through the quick results of Raw.
Okay.
And fill in the gaps.
Cool.
So as previously mentioned, Charlotte and Chris Jericho, they took on Sasha Banks and Enzo Amore. And they won.
Yeah.
Charlotte and Jericho won.
Charlotte and Jericho. Dana interrupted. Distracted Sasha Banks and Charlotte got the roll up, I think it was. Oh, no, it was natural selection.
Yeah, she won with natural selection.
Yeah. It was a good match, I thought.
Yeah, I thought it was good. I enjoyed it.
Yeah, I haven't seen a mixed tag match in a while.
It's cool to see Enzo as well branch out on his own.
Yeah, yeah, it's very cool.
Mm.
Then I think Big Cass came out after the match to help Enzo, because I think Jericho was beating him up, wasn't
yeah.
it? Yeah.
Yeah. And Kevin Owens was on commentary during this match as well, and he was very,
yeah.
very funny.
Yeah, it's great. He stole Byron's tie.
Yeah, it was very cool.
It's cool. Oh, and then after the match, the referee tried to give Charlotte the women's championship belt.
Yeah, God almighty.
I guess it wasn't watching last week.
Yeah, he was. You know, worst of it is he was probably the ref.
Yeah.
Yeah. Stupid.
Yeah.
I thought that. I was like, what the hell is he doing?
Yes.
Then he realised and Sasha just snatched the belt off. It was like,
yeah. Awkward.
Right, we'll run down the matches.
Okay.
Braun Strowman squashed a jobber mm-hmm. who got paid $1,000.
Yes. I thought it was very good. Very funny. And yeah, he was told, like, if he won, he gets $5,000 or whatever.
Yeah.
And yeah, it's very effective at making Braun Strowman look strong. I think this reverse choke slam still looks a bit crap. Other than that, I thought it was good.
This reminds me of the Master Lock Challenge from back in the day.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Because somebody eventually is going to beat Braun Strowman.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
To win the $5,000. Yeah. If this is something they're going to continue with going forward, which I imagine it will be.
Yeah.
I quite like it. It gives a little bit of substance to the squash matches.
Yeah.
So I don't hate it. But Braun is looking very strong. It's a very good way to showcase Braun. And I mean, these jobbers, you know, they're pretty funny. They're very small and they've got no chance yeah. of ever beating him. But it's cool that they've got an incentive, much like the Master Lock Challenge. I think they were offered some sort of cash incentive should they be able to escape the Master Lock.
Oh, yeah.
And that was always one of my favourite things on Raw every week.
Yeah, that's cool.
So, yeah, I quite like it.
It's giving me hope in Braun Strowman. I had none going to War, and now I've got like, maybe they might
true.
Do something right.
With this is War. True. The Shining Stars, mm-hmm. Diego and Fernando.
Yep, that's them.
they beat Goldust and R-Truth, who were too busy looking for Pokemon to, pay attention to the match. Or at least R-Truth was.
Yeah, it was dumb. I hate this match, to be honest with you.
Yeah, I hated it as well. It was stupid. I like that the Shining Stars won, because
yeah.
I think they've, had it bad since they came in.
Pretty much. Was it the announcers can't say Pokemon? They say
Pokemon. Pokemon, yeah.
Pokemon. Shut up. God damn it.
I think Pokemon Go is sort of running its course already with people. I think it's had its sort of 2 or 3 weeks in the spotlight.
Yeah.
But as with everything, WWE is late to the party.
Yeah.
Like, right, that's the...
oh, here it comes.
Pokemon Go is is popular right now. Get out there and do that.
Yeah. Do the Pokemon.
Run around backstage.
Yeah.
Yeah. Stupid. That's my Vince McMahon impression, by the way.
Solid.
It's not just thank you. It's not just me with a hoarse voice. So yeah, the Shining Stars won a match.
Yay.
And I think they had like a backstage segment afterwards, didn't they?
Yeah.
They were sort of talking about their victory.
Yeah, I think I might have skipped it. Sorry, Shining Stars. For the save time.
You're not sorry at all.
I'm not.
United States champion Rusev.
Yay.
Beat the world's strongest man. Mark Henry.
Mm-hmm. Before that, they had like a Seth Rollins and Finn Balor were in the ring talking to each other. It's like a high puppet match at SummerSlam. And it was good.
Yeah, it was fine.
Yeah, I liked it.
Yeah, sure. It was good. That match speaks for itself. It doesn't even need any hyping up.
I'm hyped
already for it. I was hyped when Finn beat Roman Reigns last week and I was like, right,
yep,
these are the matches that I want to see. Finn Balor versus Seth Rollins.
Yep, going to steal
the show.
You
could not have them on TV for 3 weeks and I would still be excited for it.
Yeah, same.
So yeah, Mark Henry returned and he was like, well, I want to be taken seriously. I don't just want to be here to mentor the young guys.
Yeah.
Take me seriously. I'm the strongest man that ever lived.
Yeah. Mm. Well, yeah.
Are you, Mark? Are you? I don't even think he won when he was in the Olympics.
I think he didn't know. He was just there. I'm at the Olympics. Yay. Oh, I lost.
Yeah.
Still, I was there.
The world's 15th strongest. In fact, it's probably not even that ranked that highly.
Yeah. Top 100, maybe.
I'm not sure.
I guess I think he's in the Olympics this year, isn't he? So we'll find out.
He's what?
I think he's in the Olympics this
year. No, I don't think he's in the Olympics.
Did you know? Oh. Guess not then.
I don't think he's competing.
Oh.
He's the WWE representative. I might be wrong. Okay. If I'm wrong, then what the hell is Mark Henry doing in the Olympics?
Yeah.
Fine. I don't think he's in the Olympics.
Okay, fair enough. I misunderstood.
Why isn't there an Olympics game this year?
I don't know. There'll be a Mario and Sonic Olympic game, I'm sure.
There already is.
Oh, yeah.
Don't BS me with that. I don't want that.
I want that.
Apparently, Shadow the Hedgehog. I know we're sort of cutting in between here.
Yeah.
But apparently, he says a bad word.
What is?
Apparently, he says a bad word.
Does he?
Yeah, there's like some footage of them playing football.
All right.
Soccer.
Soccer.
Yeah. And apparently when he misses, he says a bad word.
All right.
Look at the video.
Okay, I'll bring it up real quick. Can so, I talk more? I'll find the
Rusev video. Beat Mark Henry.
He did.
Via the accolade. It was fine. It was expected.
Yeah.
It's a shame because I really liked Mark Henry. I really liked Mark Henry when he was the world champion.
Yeah, that's cool.
Booked correctly, he can look like a complete monster. That's out the window now.
Pretty much.
Any chance of Mark Henry looking like a monster is now gone. But he's going to be representing the WWE at the Olympics, so that's fine. After the match, Roman Reigns appeared and started a feud with Rusev for the United States Championship.
Oh, yeah.
So Roman Reigns has gone from WWE World Heavyweight Champion to losing at Battleground and losing last week on Raw to Finn Balor. And now he's fighting for a mid-tier championship.
Yeah.
But I mean, I'm not mad at that.
No, it works.
I'm fine with it because Rusev is good. Mm-hmm. Reigns can put a good match on and gets a hard time. And this would be good for both of these guys.
I think so. It gives Reigns more to work with, to show what he can do.
It also takes Reigns out of the main event picture.
Yeah.
Keeps him well away from it because I think he'll win the US title.
Probably.
And he also came down sporting red on his attire.
Cool.
So he's gone from blue to red.
Sure.
That's fine.
Midnight Raw, makes sense.
Have you found that video?
Oh, I have found it right here. Let's give it a listen, shall we?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, let me unmute my laptop real quick. Bear with me. There we go. We've got the ball, kicking the ball. Whoa.
There we go.
Hold on.
I'm going to put my mic near the laptop so you can hear it.
What is it actually saying?
Hold on, play it again.
That's amazing.
I'm not going to repeat the word that we think he says, but work it out for yourself. It's amazing.
I wonder what he's actually saying. Jesus.
I know. He can't actually be saying that word.
It's really not.
But it's funny though.
It is. Sound like the Edgehog. Someone's put in the comments.
Ah.
Edgy.
Back to Raw.
Yes, okay.
After Shadow the Hedgehog has just dragged everyone down.
The filthy, filthy mouth.
Poop mouth. Titus O'Neil beat Darren Young.
We just play that game on YouTube.
We should definitely play that game.
Absolutely. During the Olympics.
Yes.
It'd be great.
Titus O'Neil beat Darren Young. Now, I thought this was weird when I saw Titus O'Neil in the ring when Darren Young was making his entrance. Titus, no entrance, just cut to him in the ring.
Yeah.
I was like, okay, this is... Then it showed some sort of backstage thing where, you know, he said, and very honestly, and exactly what everyone is thinking,
yep,
when was Darren Young great in the first place?
Yep. I think we've said that on the podcast.
I think we have, yeah.
Yeah.
So Titus O'Neil looked a beast in this match. He was beating the crap out of Darren Young. Darren Young came back into it. Titus won by cheating, by grabbing all of the tights, and won by a schoolboy pin.
Yeah.
I'm not sure where this is going. If you want my honest opinion, I think it's lazy.
Yeah, I don't know. It could be cool. I think Titus will turn heel during this. They had a backstage thing afterwards where Titus was shouting at, they're both shouting at each other, him and Bob Backlund. And then Darren Young attacked him afterwards and punched him in the face. Don't you yell at my coach like that, blah, blah, blah.
I think it's lazy. I think it's lazy booking.
I don't know.
Darren Young's not doing anything. Titus O'Neil's doing nothing. Oh, they used to be tag team partners. Let's cause friction between them again.
I'd say this has been done before, which to very little effect.
Titus as a bad guy is probably a good step.
Yeah,
it's quite funny because obviously after he cheated and got the Titus, Darren Young was left befuddled in the ring.
Yeah.
And he was like mouthing Father of the Year and all this sort of stuff. I thought that was quite cool, but it is what it is.
I don't know. It could be cool, but probably won't be.
Yeah, it's got SummerSlam pre-show written all over it.
Yeah, exactly, yes, pre-show.
Yep.
It's got another one here about Roman Reigns. What do you think with his beard?
That's fine.
I don't like it. I don't think it suits him. It's like too bushy and, I don't know, makes him, like, gives him like a round face. I don't know.
Right.
It's weird. Just want to mention it. I'm waiting on my notes here.
Right, okay.
Yeah.
Have you written down, he makes him look he's got a round face?
Yeah, I'm in that, but I'd still like, Beardo Reigns.
Right.
It's like,
I like it, it's fine.
Beardo suit him, yeah.
Nia Jax squashed Ariel Monroe.
Oh, yes, the Mohawk lady.
Yeah. I thought it was fine. Obviously, they're gonna. This is gonna happen for a few weeks until somebody comes along and fights Nia for real.
Yeah, just the female Braun Strowman.
Pretty much, yeah. That's gonna be a theme for the next a good few weeks.
Yeah,
Strowman's gonna squash everyone. Nia's gonna squash everyone, and then eventually they'll be embroiled in feuds, maybe against each other. Who knows?
Who knows?
That'd be awesome, actually.
It would be cool. Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, so Nia showed up a new finisher. It wasn't a leg drop. Yeah. Thank goodness.
It was like a fireman's carry into a power slam, and I really liked it.
Yeah, I did too. It was great. Much better than a crappy leg drop.
Much better than that. And it's good because they at least they're trying new things with it. They must have heard the feedback that the leg drop was ho-hum.
Yeah.
Hogan. Very old school.
Yes.
But she tried a powerbomb on NXT, which for me worked perfectly fine.
Yeah, good.
But this is cool. It's like... if you've seen it, you know what it looks like. But it's like a fireman's carry, and she lifts her over her shoulders, and like she's going for just a normal fireman's carry, but she does it into a power slam, and it looks very cool.
Yes, very cool.
I assume that's going to be, I guess the Sonny and Finn seal of approval.
Yes, stamped on there.
Yes. Cesaro beats, go on.
I was going to say, all Nia needs now is new music, and it's just good.
Yeah, they didn't do it this week, but... I don't know if it was intentional or not, but obviously Nia usually stands at the ramp and they focus on her eyes.
Oh, yeah.
That sucks. I'm glad they cut that out.
Yeah, that's pretty dumb.
New music, please.
Yes.
They keep, I think they're going to keep it because they keep referring to her as beautiful and she's got a $1 million smile, but she'll just knock your face off or whatever.
Yeah.
And all this sort of stuff. So they'll keep it, I think.
Yeah, probably.
WWE Tag Team Champions of the New Day. Big E, Kofi Kingston. Beat the club, Karl Anderson and Luke Gallows in a non-title match.
Oh, yes.
Very quickly,
like a cheeky roll-up. And then the club kicked the shit out of them, basically.
Yep. To put it bluntly, that's exactly what happened.
Yeah, and Xavier Woods came down to help because he was obviously banned from ringside for whatever reason. And then he got beaten up as well. And everybody got beaten up.
Yeah, the club came out of it strong. They injured Big E. And obviously, this is building towards a SummerSlam Tag Team Championship match, the club versus the New Day, which I think we are both in agreement that the club should win.
They should. And I think they will. I think they will.
Yeah. New Day have had their titles for ages, and I say it all the time, so I feel like I'm beating a dead horse here, but they don't need the titles to be successful, or to be popular.
I agree. It's
probably the correct phrase. But it was, a good segment. The club came out of it looking strong, which they should, and I predict only good things for this feud going forward.
Yeah, me too. Well, some guy in the crowd noticed the club were wearing like red and black attire. It's like, oh, red and black, Finn Balor colours, symbolism. I was like, oh yeah, that's right, random guy.
Okay. where was this, on the internet or?
No, just on, I just noticed it as I was watching it.
Oh, right, okay.
Some guy in the crowd shouted it.
Right, what, he actually said those words?
Yeah.
What, symbolism?
Yeah, some kind of crowd getting it.
Right, fair enough.
I was like, oh yeah, cool.
Cesaro beat Sheamus to win a future unspecified title shot.
Yeah, it's interesting.
I can only assume this means the Universal Championship.
Yeah, hopefully. Cesaro is, as talking about entrance music, Cesaro desperately needs new entrance music.
And a new entrance. Just a new entrance
just
new
entrance instant, yeah.
Lose the suit, lose the sunglasses. His old music was awesome.
Yeah, it was.
And then this music doesn't suit him at all.
It doesn't. It's just like a siren that makes no sense. And it's like...
Then it goes into this heavy metal music, which you know for a fact Cesaro doesn't listen to.
Yeah.
And then he comes out with a strange... Like, he's carrying one leg like he's got a dead leg. And then he rips his paper suit off.
Yeah.
Stupid. Rubbish.
Bizarre.
He beat Sheamus anyway.
Good.
And that's fine. He's going to get a title shot at whatever champion... I will assume it's the Universal title.
I would hope so, yeah. Give this man a push.
Yes. Jinder Mahal returned to WWE television.
Oh, yeah.
In a segment with Heath Slater.
Yeah.
Heath Slater, obviously, trying to get a contract with either Raw or SmackDown, and it turns up on both each week until he eventually gets one,
I guess.
Turned up with Jinder, playing up how they were 2MB and all this sort of stuff.
Yeah. Well, there needs to be a third one.
Sorry?
There needs to be a third one of you guys.
Oh, Drew.
Yeah, I guess I won't mention that because it's...
Oh, yeah, he doesn't exist, yeah.
Yeah.
He's somewhere else now. He's Jinder turned on Heath when Shane offered a contract to the winner of a match between the two.
Yeah, yep. One big kick and that was it.
Yeah, and it was a stiff looking kick as
it
well.
It was, yeah.
But I like Jinder Mahal. Again, he looks the part.
Yeah, he was a guy who got handed a crappy gimmick and had to work with it.
Crappy?
Yeah.
That's kind.
Yeah, just the worst gimmick. Ugh. But hopefully they'll do right this time and give them a fair shot.
And look, I hope they do. I mean, it's like I said, this is a fresh reset for everybody. People seemed excited to see Jinder. They were happy when he turned on Heath, and done right, I think Jinder Mahal could be good.
Yeah, I agree. And I hope he is.
And Seth Rollins beat Sami Zayn in a great main event.
Oh yeah, that was
awesome. For no reason.
Yeah, just because.
Just because they want to have an awesome match on Raw, and they had an awesome match on Raw.
Yeah.
This is the kind of wrestling that I want to see every single week.
Yep, me too.
But overall, it was a fine episode of Raw. They did mention the Cruiserweight division, and the footage they used was of the ongoing WWE Cruiserweight Classic.
Yes.
Which says to me that we might see some of those guys come to Raw.
Yes, I hope so. That'd be awesome.
We'll see. And, I mean, a division to me means a title.
Yep.
Which I think we'll see as well.
I think so.
Let's move on to SmackDown. And before we go through SmackDown, have you got notes?
You missed something. Just the Paul Heyman and Brock Lesnar being there.
Oh,
and then
that's like the main bit of Raw.
Pretty much, yeah. Paul Heyman was doing what he does best and bigging up SummerSlam and Brock Lesnar, which is awesome because he's great. And then as you were talking, out of nowhere, bloody RKO. What?
It was awesome as well.
It was awesome.
You know what? It was my favourite bit of Raw and I just missed it out like it didn't happen.
Yeah, it was very cool. The camera work was very good because like zoomed in on Brock Lesnar's face and then all of a sudden, Randy Orton out of nowhere, big RKO. And then celebrated around and then ran off.
And it was cool because they made a big deal out of him being at Raw.
Yeah, that was cool as
because
well.
Because after the security, you know, the developmental wrestlers came running down just to security.
Yeah, yeah.
They chased him out of the arena, a load of refs and all this sort of stuff. And it was really, really cool. You know, a SmackDown invader this early on into the brand split. Is it damaging? No, I don't think it is because this match was made before.
Yeah.
But it was, you know, it was great. I loved the angle. And it got me excited for a match that I've not been excited for.
Yeah, me too. But yeah, it's very cool.
Very cool.
Unexpected, and I liked it. Good, well done.
Yes, very well done.
See you on SmackDown, Brock.
Yeah. Yeah. So speaking of titles, obviously we mentioned the Cruiserweight title going to Raw. Daniel Bryan announced on like a radio podcast before SmackDown this week that they were indeed going to have a separate championship for the women on SmackDown.
Oh, they did? Oh, good.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
They're going to sort of do it right. They're not going to rush it. They're going to sort of do it so it's done right.
Yeah. That's good.
Which is good.
Hmm.
And I read that there's going to be a tag team championship for SmackDown as well.
Good.
But yeah. Game so moving on to SmackDown. You're not got any notes for SmackDown?
I don't. I watched it like literally before it came out. Before I came over to yours.
Right. Okay, good. SmackDown opened with Shane McMahon, Daniel Bryan and Randy Orton standing backstage reviewing the footage from this past Monday's Raw and the segment that we just talked about.
Yes.
And Shane sort of went overboard with the security. There's like a million developmental guys dressed as just as security.
Yeah.
Who are going to sort of walk around with Randy Orton all night.
Yeah.
And keep an eye out for Brock Lesnar. Like these guys are going to be able to stop him even if he does turn up.
Yeah.
Okay. So Dean Ambrose started the show basically talking up the fact that he's fighting Dolph Ziggler at SummerSlam.
Mm-hmm.
Ziggler came out. The two of them had a very nice, heated exchange, I thought.
Yeah, it's cool.
It was good. Made Ziggler look good. Made Dean look, you know, very assured as champion.
Yeah, yeah.
And I enjoyed the segment, and I thought it was very good. Dean basically walked out of the ring. Lights go off. Bray Wyatt comes in. Yeah. Attacks Dolph Ziggler. Sets up this week's main event.
Oh, yeah. Which was, if Bray Wyatt versus Dolph Ziggler, if Bray Wyatt wins, he takes Dolph Ziggler's spot during SummerSlam.
Yeah. Which I would have liked to see.
Yes.
But it's fine.
I've been happy either way.
Yeah, it's fine. But it's great to see Bray Wyatt sort of involved in that picture.
Yeah, that's cool.
It was advertised that AJ Styles has a message for John Cena.
Oh, yeah.
So, as I predicted last week, last week's episode was literally an introductory, let's get this number one contender nonsense out of the way.
Yeah,
and then next week we can start feuds and stuff. So yeah. that is a continuation of a feud, obviously, before the brand split.
Yes.
American Alpha debut tonight as well.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Next up, we've got The Miz said, like in a backstage segment, said he was being disrespected and all this other crap. Mm-hmm. And Shane McMahon made a triple threat match to determine the number one contender to the IC Championship at SummerSlam.
Yes, a new era number one contendership.
Yes, and it was going to be Apollo Crews, Baron Corbin, and Kalisto.
Yes.
Where's the Ultimate Fighter gone? Is he on Raw?
I think he's on Raw, yeah.
And he's not being used on Raw?
Nope.
Probably because he's...
Because he beat up Sam Gotch.
Yeah. Miz and Maurice were on commentary, as always. Good triple threat match, I thought.
Yeah, it's very good.
Apollo Crews won, which is good.
Yep, that's very good.
It looks like, I mean, we sort of were annoyed at how they sort of treated Apollo Crews in the draft, because he was... Was he in the supplemental draft?
Yeah, he was. Yeah, it's like one of the last people picked.
Which really sucked.
Yeah.
But, you know, he won the Battle Royal last week. He won the Triple Threat this week. And he's going to SummerSlam to fight The Miz for the IC title, which I think he will win.
Yes, maybe.
So this is good. We're starting to see Apollo Crews used in the right capacity.
Yes.
We just need the crowd to really get behind him now.
Yeah,
and,
I agree. I think
we'll be on to a winner. Mauro Ranallo is clearly a big fan. Said he had an Adonis... like physique.
Yeah.
And he was climbing Mount Olympus all the way to the IC Championship.
Yeah.
Personally, I think Kratos would rip his face off.
Yeah, probably.
On the way up there.
I am the god of war.
Yep. There we go. Baron Corbin attacked Kalisto after the match.
Yep.
And then Apollo Crews came to beat him up. And he got beaten up too. So Baron Corbin stands tall.
And then The Miz came out to beat up... Oh, no. Miz did Scott Gordon finale on... Apollo Crews.
Yeah.
And then, as Mr. Celebrating, Baron Corbin did end the days on The Miz.
So Baron Corbin standing tall.
Yes.
Also good.
Yes, very good.
It's good to see these guys getting the spotlight.
Yes, absolutely. I like Baron Corbin.
Yeah, sure. Next up, we have Becky Lynch taking on Eva Marie. Or do we?
Or do we, yes.
That Eva Marie entrance is bloody awful.
I kind of like it, honestly. I think it bigs her up in a way that's going to make people boo her more, which I think is what they're going for.
It's not that I'm bothered about. It's the way that the voiceover's done. It's too slow.
It is a bit slow, isn't it? Yeah.
My favourite bit of the entrance is when Eva Marie starts taking her jacket off and it's like, holy crap, she is super hot.
Yep, she's got a good body, yes.
She's awesome.
She knows how to flaunt it.
Yeah, I'm a big fan of that.
Yeah. Now if she can just wrestle a match, that'd be cool.
Yeah. So before the match even started, Eva Marie sold injury when she came off the rope. After her entrance.
Yeah.
I did notice in her face that something happened or you know, obviously she made it obvious that that's what was going to happen. Yeah. I'm sure it was work.
Yeah, it absolutely was, yeah.
I think this is going to be like a recurring thing.
Yeah, she's going to be like afraid to wrestle and...
She's going to keep blowing matches off and eventually win the SmackDown Women's Championship. That's what's going to happen.
Probably, yeah. People are going to hate it and it's going to be glorious.
Yep. Are we starting to like Eva Marie?
I think so. But because they're doing what they should be doing with her. It's like she's...
Making people hate her.
Yeah, she's like the top heel, top female heel they've got, because everybody hates her already.
Yeah, and she's like the female Roman Reigns.
Yeah, except...
Like everyone hates her.
Yeah, except they're actually doing what they should be doing with Roman Reigns and turn their heel and making everybody hate her even more.
Yeah.
Which is great.
Yeah, which is fantastic.
Yeah.
More power to you, Eva Marie. I hope it works out.
Yeah, yeah. Now Destiny needs to learn how to actually wrestle. If she can do that, then they're onto a winner.
Yes. But until then, I will continue to enjoy at least the physical aspect of your entrance every single week.
Yeah, I just hope he carries on training with like Brian Kendrick and that, so he can, whilst he's not actually wrestling, you know.
Yeah, sure. On the SmackDown Live pre and post game set,
right?
Now, where was it? Was it in the crowd like it usually is, or was it somewhere else?
Good question. I don't know.
Because they had like a whole sports like a sports center style set. Like with Renee Young sitting there. Obviously, she's exclusive to SmackDown. I'm assuming that's because Dean's on there and Aaron Archer in real life.
Oh, yeah.
And she was sitting... Anyway, either way, she was sitting with Carmella.
Mm.
And she was talking about how great it is to be on SmackDown and yada, yada, yada. Natalya comes, being the heel, and they set up a match for later on in the night.
Yeah.
Whatever.
Cool. It's fine.
Yeah, sure. I want to know where that set is.
Yeah.
Because it doesn't show it anywhere. I just don't understand where it is. It's like it's there for the live crowd.
Hmm.
But I don't know where it is.
Weird.
Did you watch... I'm assuming you didn't. Did you watch the Smack Talk... Talking Smack thing after?
No, I didn't get time.
No.
Did you?
No.
Okay.
It was on. I fell asleep with I do most nights with the WWE Network on. I just play... do the live feed.
Yeah, yeah.
And it just goes through. Like, when Lottie woke up in the morning, it was just on.
Oh, I fell up.
So, yeah. Next up, the Vaude Villains are being fed to American Alpha. They're debuting on the main roster, American Alpha.
Yay.
Now, do you think the Vaude villains are being punished for Simon Gotch versus the Ultimate Fighter on backstage at SmackDown a couple of weeks back?
Possibly, yeah. But then they were already quite low on the card before then, so I don't know. It might just be Vince and not liking like the gimmick or whatever.
I think Gotch versus the Ultimate Fighter had something to do with it.
Yeah, it could be. I hope it's in the end for like the Vaude villains. I hope they do get a push eventually, but I don't know.
Well, if there's going to be a tag division on SmackDown, like with belts,
yeah, that's true.
Then you know, hopefully they'll be a part of the scene.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, what? Where are the Ascension? Are they on Raw or are they on SmackDown?
I don't remember actually. Let's look it up.
Okay. Well, either way,
I think possibly Raw.
I don't know.
I'll Google it now.
You're gonna were you then googling it?
Yeah.
Okay. Google is the oracle.
Yeah.
Of all things in the world.
God of all knowledge.
So no entrance for the Vaude villains. The crowd were fine for American Alpha's entrance.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what crowds suck. I mean, why can't they just like go to the cities that they know are going to go mental for people?
Yeah,
or just go to Chicago, go to Canada, and somewhere in Texas, and where they actually pop for these people.
Yeah.
Either way, it was a very you know, basic formula tag team match. American Alpha picked up the win,
mm-hmm.
But it was good.
Yeah, it's good. I like it. It's good. Showcase for the American Alpha, what they can do.
They should have got a jobber team in.
Oh, yeah, probably. Because it does kind of make the Vaude villains look not that great.
Again, let's blame Simon Gotch for this.
Yeah, goddammit, Simon. Why would you pick a fight with the Ultimate Fighter?
Yeah, exactly. Don't pick a fight with the Ultimate Fighter who's already 3-0 in backstage fights before you get there.
Yeah, yeah. It's entered on SmackDown. So, oh, yeah, good. That'd be good.
So if there is going to be a tag team division, the Ascension could maybe start their renaissance.
Yes, hopefully.
Come back. But yeah, I think they should have got a jobber team maybe to fight the American Alpha first.
Yeah.
Instead of sort of feeding them to... instead of feeding the Vaude villains to them. Either way, great to see American Alpha. Mm-hmm. They're going to be massive. Yep. They'll probably win the first ever SmackDown Tag Team Championships.
Yeah, guarantee it.
Yep. Up next, we've got AJ Styles with a message for John Cena.
Yes.
Styles didn't even get his first words out before Cena interrupted him. They wanted to talk face to face. They showed highlights of Cena hosting yet another reward show.
Yeah.
Seems like he's super popular at the minute among pop culture.
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah.
Are they memes?
Good exchange between the two.
Yeah, it's good.
Right.
It's a standard John Cena promo, which I've seen 100 times before.
Yeah, it is. I love the WWE. When am I going to leave the WWE? Never. Oh,
yeah.
Cheers, John. That's exactly what I wanted to hear.
Yeah.
You know, blah, 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 all this sort of stuff. And it was fine. AJ, all this was basically just to set up AJ Styles versus John Cena at SummerSlam.
Yeah.
Fine. Hopefully it'll end there and then we can see AJ Styles go for the WWE Championship instead.
Hopefully.
But yeah, it's fine.
Yeah. It was, yeah.
I liked AJ in this. I liked Cena.
Hmm.
Both good. That's all you can really say about it.
Yeah. I hope AJ needs to win clean at SummerSlam.
AJ definitely needs to win.
Yeah. Otherwise, it's going to make him look garbage.
Well, he lost the Battleground.
Yeah.
He lost in the Fatal 4-Way. No, the Six-Pack Challenge, sorry, last week on SmackDown.
Mm-hmm.
Clean.
Mm-hmm.
So if he loses clean to Cena, what's the point?
Yeah. Didn't win his card. We've seen him is like when the club interfered and stuff.
Yeah.
So yeah.
Hmm.
Please win.
Either way, it was fine. It was a good promo, and I'm excited for the match at SummerSlam because they had a really good match at not Battleground. Which one was it?
Payback. Yeah.
Before the club interfered,
mm-hmm.
and ruined the match, and rubbished the stipulation that was in place where they were banned from ringside.
Yeah, that was dumb. Very didn't have it.
Anyway, next up, the security all around ringside. And it's not to protect Fandango.
It's not, no.
It's to protect Randy Orton.
Or Fandango.
So we've got Randy Orton versus Fandango. Guess who won?
Fandango?
Nobody won.
Oh, yeah, nobody did. Yeah, that's right.
Well, Orton won by disqualification.
Oh, well, yeah.
Either way. Brock Lesnar came down.
Surprise.
It was very cool, though.
Yeah, the security sucks. How did he get in? How do you miss a guy like Brock Lesnar?
Why have 40 security if none of them can keep one man out?
Yeah, exactly.
They're all too busy looking at Randy Orton RKOing Fandango in the ring.
Yeah.
They're like, oh my God, amazing. And then Brock Lesnar just comes in and F5s Randy Orton.
Wanders in like nothing. Don't mind me.
Yeah, but it was good. I enjoyed it.
Yeah, it's fine. I did think Brock could have done a bit more because he kind of hit the F5 and just kind of went, oh, I'm off now. See ya. And I don't know.
It's no different to really what Randy Orton did. But like Brock said, when he went backstage, it was just retaliation.
Yeah, it's fine.
Just getting his own back.
I know, but I want Brock to be like this monster heel who just destroys everyone. But at that time, he's just kind of like, FY1, FY, I'm done. See ya.
Mm. But I mean, again, they made a big deal out of him, a Raw guy being on SmackDown.
Yeah, that was good.
By Shane and that coming sort of coming down and getting him out of, from ringside.
Yeah, I do like that.
But it's good. It makes it feel like they are separate brands.
Yeah.
And these guys shouldn't be there.
Exactly. I hope they don't do it too often, otherwise that would kind of ruin it, but just the ones to try.
Tell me, are you now hyped for Brock Lesnar versus Randy Orton at SummerSlam?
Yeah, I am. I think it'll be a good match.
I'm more hyped than I was.
Yeah, I'm not as hyped as I am for like Seth Rollins versus Finn Balor, but it'll be a good match, I think.
Yeah.
It'll be solid.
Yeah.
I think Randy will win.
Really?
That's
a big prediction.
I think so.
Okay.
Do you think Brock will win?
I do. I always think Brock will win, though.
Yeah.
But I don't know. We'll see.
It's probably a smart bet, but we'll see.
We'll see. All right. So next up, Ziggler versus Bray Wyatt. The winner is the number one contender for the WWE Championship.
Yes.
At SummerSlam. Spoiler. Ziggler wins.
Yes. Kind of expected him to. Would have been kind of harsh to take that away from Dolph Ziggler. So
the way they were building the match up, I thought they might sort of have him actually have him lose.
All right.
But then sort of maybe have him like a road to redemption thing.
Like a Roman Reigns kind of thing.
Yeah. I thought, you know, Ziggler's going to lose and he's really, some big Dolph Ziggler underdog comeback sort of thing.
Yeah.
But no, it was fine. Good match.
Mm-hmm.
Bray is great. Ziggler is fine.
One moment I thought Bray hurt his leg because he went to like some roll up and he quickly grabbed his leg and was like, oh god, not another injury, come on.
Yeah.
Luckily he was okay.
He had some really shitty luck.
Yeah.
But it was fine. It was a good match.
Yeah. Bray Wyatt got tucked off the corner cover thing.
Mm.
17 in a while, which is cool. And then
that's pretty old school, that.
Yeah, that's pretty old school. I like that.
Yeah.
And Dolph Ziggler took advantage of it. Hit with a super kick and won the match.
Yeah. It's like that's going to be Dolph Ziggler's finishing move going forward.
Yeah, I'm fine with that.
Yeah, me too.
I think what they should do is have other people use it less, so it seems more effective for Dolph to use it.
Yeah, you're right, because a lot of people do use it. Styles uses it.
Yeah.
Kevin Owens uses it. Yeah, maybe have people use it less. So
Usos. Usos use it as well, yeah.
Yeah. When I say Usos, you say.
Maybe a super kick.
Maybe
a super kick. So
after the match, Dolph Ziggler was celebrating. Then Eric Rowan came out of nowhere.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so it looks like they're keeping Rowan and Bray Wyatt together. And like I said, eventually I do think Luke Harper will come back and join them and there'll be the three of them again.
Definitely.
Fine. Then we could have Harper and Rowan going for the tag titles perhaps and Bray doing single stuff instead of messing around with that.
That'd be cool.
But it was fine. It was good to see Ziggler get the win and keep that match against Ambrose, because I think it'd be fine, and I like the chemistry between Ambrose and Ziggler.
Yep.
Also good to see the Wyatt standing strong at the end of the show.
Yes, it's all good. So good.
Overall, it was a good episode of SmackDown this week, better than last week's.
Yeah.
Mainly because we've seen movement on what's going to happen going forward.
Yeah, things are happening.
What did you think? How did you feel about Raw and SmackDown this week? How would you rate the two?
That's very good. I'd give like a 7, same thing you said, and then SmackDown put like an 8. 7 and 8.
I think SmackDown was better than Raw this week.
Yeah.
Only because it's a shorter, quick fire show, and I like that.
Yeah. Well, the only thing SmackDown didn't like is that there's no proper women's match. It's like that the thing with Eva Marie and whoever it was, Becky Lynch, that never started, and then we had Natalya attacking Carmella before the match.
Yeah.
That didn't start. It's like, got this awesome women's division, but you're just not using it. What are you doing?
It'll get there.
Yeah. I'm sort of setting up for next week, I know, but. Could have at least one match.
Yeah, it'll get there. Because they're short on time on SmackDown.
Yeah, that's true.
Obviously, Raw, you can pad it out with whatever you want because it just goes on forever. But like with SmackDown, they could run with like the NXT formula and sort of like they did last week, American Alpha debuting next week.
Mm.
They could sort of have different things and miss things off certain weeks and things like that.
So, yeah.
Apparently, Kurt Hawkins was backstage this week and will be making his return soon.
All right, okay. Cool. Okay.
Yeah.
Fine.
Fine.
Hey, Hawkins and Wyatt can get back together. Or maybe not.
God almighty. Is that Wyatt can grow his hair again?
Yeah. I think he hated that. I didn't say that in interviews. He hated the long hair.
Yeah. Either way, it's week two was good.
Yeah.
We're still going fairly strong. Raw set the bar way too high for them to be able to touch anything they did last week.
Yeah. But it's got good momentum going forward, I think.
I think so, yeah. I'm excited for SummerSlam. I'm excited for the build.
I am, yes. That'd be good.
But yeah, so it's good. We're getting to the last round of the Cruiserweight Classic this week. Are you excited?
Yeah, I'm excited. With it? Yep, definitely.
It's the best thing wrestling-wise on TV at the minute.
Yep.
Or okay. At least that we can watch.
Yeah.
So yeah, I'm excited for it. NXT is going to be good this week as well, I think.
Yep.
I think we're going to see some new faces this week.
Oh yeah?
Sweet. So I'm excited for that.
Me too.
But yeah, I'm happy with where WWE is right now.
Yeah, me too.
The worst thing about WWE at the minute is literally WWE 2K17.
Yeah, pretty much.
Mm.
Oh dear.
And the fact that Sasha Banks can't say WWE.
Oh, can she not? What did she say?
She's like WE.
WE.
She just can't say it. It's like WE. Like one W and an E. We.
Maybe she's drinking before the match. WWE.
Maybe. Maybe she just can't champion. Say it. We shouldn't take the piss out of her.
She's awesome. However.
She is awesome. Anything else you want to talk about?
I think that's it.
Yeah?
Just about, yeah.
Okay. Thank you very much for listening. Another long one this week.
Yeah.
Touching nearly an hour and a half again.
Good.
I don't know what we're filling this podcast with.
Yeah.
But when we think there's not much gaming news, we just talk about it for ages.
Yeah. And then, yeah, wrestling's getting a lot of attention maybe because of obviously Raw and SmackDown.
It is. There's more to talk about than there has sort of been.
Yeah, because SmackDown was kind of just looked up the pre-taped results and talking about it.
That's true. We used to just skim through. We used to talk about it during the Raw stuff.
Like, yeah, pretty much.
But now we've got both shows to cover. And I like it.
Yeah, me too.
That's good. So, please do subscribe to our podcast on iTunes. Mm-hmm. You can also find us across all podcast services. Subscribe to our YouTube channel, Sonny and Finn Play.
Yes.
There's Let's Plays to come, more live streams, and of course with SummerSlam weekend coming up, we'll have NXT TakeOver Brooklyn 2.
Yep.
And SummerSlam live streams.
Yes.
That's all for this week. We are the Sonny and Finn Show. I'm Sonny.
I'm Ben.
And we'll speak to you next time, guys. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Goodbye.